iPhone 18 pricing may go up in 2026, and the cause could be its upgraded processor. The iPhone 18 may end up with a larger price tag than its predecessors. Apple's planned deployment of a cutting-edge 2nm manufacturing technology for its next-generation chipset could dramatically boost production costs, potentially leading to increased prices for the iPhone 18 series when it releases in September 2026. According to sources from Taiwan, the forthcoming CPU, believed to be labeled as the A20 or A20 Pro, will rely on advanced 12-inch wafers made of roughly 100 layers. This technological leap, although promising increased performance and efficiency, comes with a high price tag that may force Apple to either swallow reduced profit margins or pass the costs on to consumers. Apple's longtime manufacturing partner, Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company, is poised to boost costs for its sophisticated silicon wafers. 2-nanometer wafers are estimated to cost around $30,000 each, which is a big leap from the $20,000 price tag for the existing 3-nanometer technology. This wafer price increase leads directly to higher per-unit costs for the chipset. Reports indicate the A20 or A20 Pro might cost Apple close to $280 per CPU, which is nearly an 87% rise over the estimated $150 for the A19 Pro, and several times higher than the roughly $50 connected with the A18 Pro. In contrast, rival Samsung is positioning itself aggressively by pricing its 2-nanometer gate-all-around wafers at roughly $20,000, about 33% lower than TSMC's rate and comparable to Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company 3-nanometer pricing. Note that TSMC is anticipated to have somewhat greater production yields than Samsung. What makes the 2M process so groundbreaking is Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company adoption of nanosheet transistor architecture, often known as gate all around. This signals a major transition from the long dominant FinFET technology. The gate all around permits current to be controlled from all four sides of the channel using vertically stacked nanosheets. This considerably minimizes current leakage, improves electrical control, and optimizes power efficiency. In short, future processors will not only be quicker, but also cooler and more battery efficient, an advance iPhone customers have anxiously awaited. The Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company 2-nanometer technology is predicted to top the industry in transistor density and power performance. Compared to the existing 3-nanometer and 3E technology, 2-nanometer devices are 10 to 15% faster at the same power level or 25 to 30% more power efficient at the same performance. About 15% higher for mixed chip designs, logic plus analog plus SRAM, up to 20% higher for pure logic chips, Apple's chip evolution emphasizes this breakthrough. The A13 Bionic utilized in the iPhone 11 featured roughly 90 to 95 million transistors per M2. By the time the iPhone 15 Pro came with the 3-nanometer A17 Pro, that number had soared to 220 to 290 million. With the A20 Pro, transistor density may reach 310 to 330 million / M2, roughly tripling performance since the iPhone 11. What follows after 2-nanometer? The A16 Angstrom era. Looking ahead, Apple and Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company are already eyeing A16 to 16 Angstrom as the next key step, not just in shrinking, but in power delivery. The Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company aims to use super power rail technology, relocating power supply lines to the backside of the wafer. This brings power straight to the transistor's source and drain terminals, decreasing voltage loss and enabling more compact semiconductor layouts. If Apple keeps on pace, the next iPhone 18 Pro Max and subsequent models, like the iPhone 20, won't just be more powerful in the usual sense. They'll also be smarter, more sustainable, and thermally optimized, assuring a better user experience with less heat and longer battery life. And with rivals racing to catch up, the 2-nanometer milestone and beyond will surely unleash a new age of competitiveness in global mobile innovation. Apple is coming off the heels of a redesign with the iPhone 17 Pro Max, so it's unlikely that its successor will alter the design language considerably. That said, there is talk of modifying the two-tone style, which proved fairly polarizing on release. Expected to begin commercial production in late 2026, this discovery could revolutionize chip stability, efficiency, and thermal performance. Alongside the normal 2-nanometer process, Taiwan Semiconductor Manufacturing Company is set to develop N2P, an upgraded variant designed for performance. It is intended to give an extra 5 to 10% speed gain at the same power level. Transistor density statistics for N2P remain unknown, but its influence on high-end devices could be enormous. 7. iPhones of the future. Smarter, cooler, and longer lasting. All of these innovations promise to make future iPhones quicker, more responsive, better at AI processing, and more energy efficient, a vital trait for gaming and demanding apps. Beyond that, the iPhone 18 Pro Max is going to be much heavier, according to the leaker Instant Digital. On Weibo, the tipster wrote that the phone will be roughly 10 grams weightier than the 233 grams iPhone 17 Pro Max, making it the heaviest Apple mobile ever, although that will likely be short-lived if the iPhone Fold arrives at the same time, as expected. While the leaker doesn't give any justification for the additional mass, it appears likely that it's either for a larger battery, a more advanced camera array, or a mix of the two. Either way, it's certainly going to make the difference between the 165 grams iPhone Air and the heavy Pro Max more noticeable. There are also rumors of Apple continuing on its continuous goal to minimize the Face ID cutout on the front of the phone. Face ID is set to be moved under the screen, with the punch-hole camera possibly to be relocated to the upper left of the screen. As for the screen itself, expect the iPhone 18 Pro Max to remain the same 6.9-inch size that Apple has utilized since the iPhone 16 Pro Max. Finally, a new generation of iPhones comes with new color choices. While they aren't going to be confirmed until much closer to that projected September debut, reports say Apple is testing burgundy, purple, and coffee brown tints for the iPhone 18 Pro lineup. In the past, Apple's substantial camera advancements have been reserved for the iPhone Pro models. For 2026, one upgrade will apparently be entirely for the iPhone 18 Pro Max, with the normal Pro missing out, a variable aperture camera. That's major news for photography aficionados, allowing users to alter the amount of light entering the camera lens. While the prior three iPhone Pro devices have had a fixed f/1.78 aperture, the iPhone 18 Pro Max would make the setting adjustable for significantly more freedom when you photograph. iPhone 18 Pro Max users could adapt the camera to its surroundings, limiting the quantity of light in bright settings and increasing it in tougher dark environments. A variable aperture could potentially allow better control over depth of field. It's a feature that absolutely deserves the Pro designation, given that variable aperture more typically occurs in professional DSLR cameras, though Samsung explored it with the Galaxy S9 and S10 before it was retired. It would seem unusual to make a crucial photography function limited to the Pro Max, but it wouldn't be the first time Apple has done something like this. The 5x telephoto lens was only available on board the iPhone 15 Pro Max and not the iPhone 15 Pro, for example. Beyond that, we don't have specifics on the camera specs, leading us to expect more of the same from the iPhone 17 Pro Max arrangement. Still, there is one other planned adjustment on the photographic front. The camera control button will supposedly be streamlined, with capacitive functionality removed, leaving only a pressure sensor. That's not good for aficionados of the feature, but it's better than the previous rumor, which was that the camera control feature was to be deleted altogether. 9. iPhone 18 Pro Max Outlook. At the moment, the prognosis for the iPhone 18 Pro Max is fairly hazy. That's unsurprising given how far out we are from the phone's release, but the image will become obvious over time, and we'll continue to update this post as more facts come into view. Even now, there are reasons for Apple devotees to be enthusiastic. The A20 Pro chip could give enormous performance benefits, and the variable rate aperture could be beneficial for photographers. Plus, everything we know so far, from the efficiency improvements of the core chipset and modem to the bigger body, hints that this might be a stamina beast. In other words, there are plenty of reasons to keep a careful eye on what develops between now and September on the iPhone 18 Pro Max rumor front. An earlier iPhone 18 introduction might have far-reaching repercussions on Apple's larger product selection. For instance, the iPhone 17, anticipated to debut in fall 2025, would suffer a shorter lifecycle if its successor arrived just 6 months later. This reduced timescale could impact consumer purchase decisions, as buyers consider the merits of waiting for the next edition. Additionally, the iPhone 18 is reported to have a new generation of A-series chipsets, offering increased performance and energy efficiency. These enhancements could further differentiate the portfolio, underscoring Apple's dedication to producing breakthrough technologies. The prospect for more frequent upgrades may also redefine how Apple positions its devices, creating new possibilities to engage with its audience. 10. Future innovations on the horizon. The iPhone 18 is not the only product garnering enthusiasm. Rumors say that Apple may launch a foldable iPhone as early as 2026, maybe with the Pro and Pro Max models. This device might offer a bold move forward in style and functionality, catering to users seeking greater adaptability. Additionally, a lightweight iPhone Air is anticipated to appear in 2027, emphasizing portability and a streamlined design philosophy. These developments reflect Apple's efforts to expand its product offerings while keeping its reputation for innovation. By exploring new form factors and design concepts, the corporation might appeal to a broader range of consumers, further strengthening its position as a market leader. 11. Adapting to a competitive landscape. Apple's anticipated shift in launch strategy may represent its response to an increasingly competitive market. By delaying releases, the corporation could fight rivals' frequent flagship debuts while keeping its audience engaged throughout the year. This strategy may also suggest a broader transition in Apple's update cycle, with more frequent but modest upgrades across its product lines. Such a plan might change the rhythm of iPhone launches, injecting an element of uncertainty into Apple's typically regular calendar. For customers, this offers more opportunity to sample the latest advancements. For Apple, it signals the strategic adaptation to a dynamic marketplace, reinforcing its dedication to technological excellence and its ability to interact with its audience in new and significant ways. So, that's it for today's video. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more tech news and updates. And goodbye.